My name is Amy, and today I'll be going through how I use two types of journaling to stay grounded and on track, even in like the hellscape that is quarantine/2020.
So the first thing I do is morning pages, which is what it sounds like. It's pages that you do in the morning. And basically, I just use like a regular old composition notebook for this. So I think a lot of people can't get into journaling because they think it has to follow a certain format. For example, it has to start with Dear Diary and then follow with a recounting of everything that happened in your day and then all your deepest, innermost thoughts about your relationships and the world. So instead of the morning pages having to have a recounting of your day, for example, you can just freeform talk about anything that's on your mind, really. A new idea that you want to try, a quote that you've been thinking about, a review of a TV show you watched. It can even not be words. I'm a very inner monologue kind of person. I like have arguments with myself. So my morning pages are just like one long run-on sentence. But you can doodle, you can write poetry, just anything. Yeah, so that's what I really love about this practice. And one unexpected benefit of this is that since you're writing every day about what's on the top of your mind, you start to notice patterns in what you care about and what you think about. And those can be positive patterns or negative patterns. But like the fact that you're aware that there's a pattern means you can reinforce the positive ones and also do something about the negative ones. So a positive pattern for me was that I kept noticing I wanted to express myself more. One way that I've always been into is making videos. So noticing that pattern in my morning pages inspired me to make this video. So it wouldn't be here without that. And in terms of negative patterns, I think that's especially important if you're at home a lot. It can be easy to get stuck in a rut and not know why you're stuck. And so seeing where you're dissatisfied through your thoughts in the morning pages is really helpful for that. And honestly, I don't even get too worried when I skip a day or two because I found that counterintuitively, when I'm less harsh on myself for breaking a habit, I do that habit more. I feel like a lot of times we think, oh, the harder I am on myself, then the more motivated I will be to do the habit. But I found the opposite is true. If I beat myself up, then I just kind of feel bad and then I don't want to do productive things or like good habits. So the second journaling technique, I guess, that I wanted to talk about is bullet journaling. I know that bullet journaling is nothing new under the sun, and you might have heard of it. You know all those like agendas that you can buy at Staples or at stationery stores where they lay out like the year or the week or the month in a certain format and you fill that in? But if you've ever not used them because they seem too rigid or they don't fit your needs, bullet journaling is kind of the solution to all that. And the key insight of bullet journaling is that you can make your own agenda planner that's tailored to your own specific needs. And you can do that by using a blank notebook. When it comes to my planner, I just want it to be minimalistic. What I do is just a really simple weekly spread. I divide the page into four sections, one for each day of the week. And the last section is kind of my like week overall space. This is where I put habits that I want to keep track of. So I've always tried to do monthly trackers, but I found, like I talked about in the morning pages part, that it's a bit too high pressure. Like if you miss a day in a month, then I don't know, it just haunts you, that like blank spot for the entire month. So for me, weekly habit trackers are a bit less intimidating, less intense. And also the really nice thing is that you can just kind of switch up the habits from week to week. So I also have a little chart where I keep track of how many hours I sleep each night. And the kind of overall purpose of this section is to make sure I'm not neglecting the basics. I don't know if you've ever felt like, I feel shitty today, but I can't figure out why. For me, a lot of times, if I feel a little out of sorts and I go into the section, I can see, oh, I didn't sleep enough last night, or I haven't talked to friends in a while, or I haven't gone outdoors in a while. And that can clue me into why I might be feeling this way. Okay, now that we've talked about that last section, let's talk about the little squares for each day. So at the top of every day, I usually put my events and meetings that day. This is nice because I usually fill those in for the whole week beforehand, and it lets me know that every day I have something to look forward to. Then I will put squares for the to-dos that day. And then my favorite type is a plus sign for any, I call them highlights of my day, but basically this is like, if I discovered a cool video, then I'll put a plus sign and then the name of the video. Or if I had like a really good memory that day, I'll write that down with a plus sign. And so at the end of the week, I can kind of see this holistic view of what happened in my week. And I think that is so important for when many of your days look pretty much the same. It can be hard to remember what was worthwhile that day. And so if you can see the things you accomplished, meetings and talks you had with other people, and the little highlights that brightened up your days, then it just seems like there is more that is worthwhile in your life. Kind of continuing on that theme, there are two other spreads that I use, which also help me like further keep track of the worthwhile things in life. The first one is what I call an inputs tracker. It basically contains all the books, movies, TV shows, long YouTube videos, whatever that I've consumed. I just put them in here, put a rating, and then put like two words that remind me of the thing or evoke the kind of feelings that it gave me. Here, I chose to combine like books, movies, TV shows, etc., because I found that it's kind of an artificial split in the first place. All kind of like things that go as inputs into my mind. And so that's why I just put them all under this inputs tracker. I think for me, this relieves some of the focus on productivity and output, because finding quality inputs and consuming them is also a really valuable activity in life. Having this helps me track of them and look back on them, and also know that like even if I didn't complete that many to-dos that day, if I read like a life-changing book or a really great movie, that is also something to be proud of and to put focus on. The second one is called weekly wins. Basically, every week I will write down three things that I would consider wins. And they don't necessarily have to be productivity based as well. It can be just like improving yourself as a person, or like pushing yourself out of your comfort zone in some way. I know that's really vague, but just the act of looking back on the week and picking out three of the things that you're most proud of, it's really important to me. You do less in a day than you think, but then you do more in a week than you think. Having like different lenses, day, week, month, year, that you can put your focus on is really helpful for maintaining perspective. So yeah, that's how I use journaling to kind of keep myself on track, keep my morale up. And I think like the main takeaway here is that journaling doesn't have to be any particular format. You can tailor it for yourself however you like. Journaling is using like writing things down to self-reflect. And another main takeaway is that when I think about the good things that happened in my day or in my week, my life is improved. And so it's really not a novel concept, but this is just my method and what has worked for me. So I hope that this has been helpful, and I would love to hear how you guys use journaling methods to improve your life in the comments. Yeah, thank you so much, and I'll see you guys next time.